A social club mixed some $3 per pound tea with some $4 per pound tea to make a 2-pound package of tea valued at $6.25. How many pounds of each type of tea were used to make the mixture? So I'm going to draw a little sketch here just to kind of visualize what's going on. There's some $3 tea plus some $4 tea. It's going to make a 2-pound tea of $6.25. And of course, this is not a valid equation. This is just kind of giving me an idea. I mean, we don't know how much of the $3 tea, we don't know how much of the $4 tea. We do know that this is a 2-pound package. So this is 2 pounds here. But we don't know how much of each, the $3 and $4. And really, that's what the question is asking, is how many pounds of each type of tea. Well, I think we can turn this model into an equation. Or actually, we'll make two equations. First of all, there's the overall cost of the tea, and that's the $6.25. So basically, $3 per pound times x, which I'll use x to represent the amount of the $3 tea, plus $4 per pound times y, is $6.25. And the $6.25, we don't need this 2 pounds for the $6.25. This $6.25 is not a rate, it's the actual value of the 2-pound package of tea. So that's actually our first equation, is 3x plus 4y equals 6.25. Remember, x is the amount of $3 tea, y is the amount of $4 tea. And it's important to write down what your variables are, or your unknowns, so that way you can remember as you're working through what you're doing. Okay, so that's one equation talking about how you create the $6.25. And there's another equation that we can use related to the amount or the weight of the tea, because the amount of the $3 tea plus the amount of the $4 tea used, the total weight has to be 2 pounds. So I could just say x plus y is 2. X being the amount of $3 tea used in pounds, and y the amount of pounds of the $4 tea. Okay, so we have two equations now, and we can go ahead and use those equations to solve. And I'm going to solve them graphically. I'm going to use the graphing calculator. Now, when you have equations written in this standard form, you need to rewrite them into slope-intercept form or function form to put them in the calculator. So I'll go ahead and rewrite this first equation first, the 3x plus 4y equals 625. So when I get this y by itself, I'm going to subtract 3x from both sides. So I'm going to get 4y equals negative 3x plus 625. Then I'm going to divide everything by 4. Okay, now I'm actually going to leave it like this, because this y equals this whole thing, negative 3x plus 625 divided by 4. And you could go ahead and split this up and simplify. I'm just going to leave it like that, because in the calculator, we can use parentheses to enter it in just like this, and it'll be OK. Let's look at the second equation, x plus y equals 2. Just subtract x from both sides to get the y by itself, and you get y equals negative x plus 2. Or it's 2 minus x, if you want to think of it that way. Okay, let's get the calculator going and enter these two equations in. So y equals, and this first equation is going to be, well, it's negative 3x plus 6.25 all divided by 4. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put parentheses around the numerator. So it'll be negative 3x with the open parentheses first plus 6.25. Close parentheses. Now all that is going to be divided by 4. Now see how using the parentheses saved me a simplification step. I didn't have to split up the 3x and the 6.25. I didn't have to split up the negative 3x and the 6.25 to make two fractions. I just entered it all like that. Next equation is y equals negative x plus 2, so negative x plus 2. Now let's graph. Okay, so here I have a linear system and there is a point of intersection. Let's go ahead and calculate what that is. So I'm going to hit second and calc, which is F4. And then option 5 is intersect. And I'm just going to hit enter, 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 and follow the prompts. So x is 1.75, y is 0.25. Okay, so now we have our values for x and y. So let's take a look back at what the variables mean. X is the amount of $3 t, y is the amount of $4 t. So x being 1.75, that means 1.75 pounds of the $3 t were used. And there were 0.25 pounds of the $4 t used to make the mixture that was worth $6.25. Okay, so let me just review the process. I kind of drew this little model here to start off with to help processing the information that was given, and use that model to create two equations. Then I knew I was going to solve using a calculator and graphing, so I went ahead and took each equation and wrote it in function form, entered the equations in the calculator, looked at the graph, and used the calculator to find the point of intersection, and then used that point of intersection to interpret the information and come up with the answer.